part of a group of furniture makers that is centered around the area of New Hampshire, where there's a very, very long tradition of very, very high quality woodworking. One of the ways we've gotten to sort of present the next generation or encourage the next generation is we have a category of emerging artists that sort of is the first level to be part of the membership, as well as we've got visiting artists, as well as we mentor in the prison system. And we also have a studio fellowship program, which is basically the idea of working with a master for a while. Most of my classes are run under 2 weeks in length. I've got one group of men that I've been working with and some young men that go on once a month for the whole winter season. We go about 6 months. And that's the most fruitful time in terms of really working and mentoring these individuals. Otherwise, I'm just at 2 weeks or less at a class. So I've got to give them the most exposure I can. And a lot of it comes down to just feeling, expressing to them, the feeling that they should relax. And don't worry about doing everything all at once. Don't try it about making the most incredible piece you've ever made. You've got to start somewhere and add your skills and add more skills. And give them that sort of feeling of confidence. But the reality is they've got to have a lot of ambition themselves. And they've got to have a lot of determination. And then you've got this whole added burden of expense. It's an expensive profession to get involved in when you consider you've got to buy wood more or less at retail. Then you've got to buy the tools, machines, hand tools, whatever it is. Every one of those is expensive, we know that. Then you've got rent or shop space. And then you've got to go out and find clients. So it's a tremendous amount of determination saying, this is what I want to do, this is the life I want to do, and sticking with it more than anything. I talk about this furniture being passed on to your children and your children's children. Yeah. The key is to not build something that's got sort of modern pop appeal, that it's going to have sort of the timeless appeal. That's the tricky part. And I think in some ways that's the trickiest thing to convey to a young person, not how to use a plane, not how to go procure wood, even not how to market himself, but how to produce those kinds of design that has something about it that's going to be appealing. Every time you go and look at it, it's going to give you that pleasure that I think a really beautifully well-made piece does have. What I'm doing the most, I think, is just presenting who I am, the fact that I've been successful what I'm doing, I really love what I'm doing, and in some ways that's probably the best ambassador for going forward.